On a hot day like today, the pool is a great place to cool off. But before you dive in, do you know how to protect yourself from waterborne illnesses? First News reporter Alex George breaks down the do's and don'ts of safe swimming.
Cryptosporidium.
Or more commonly known as crypto. It's a germ that causes diarrhea and can be a nightmare for pools and swimmers.
It's a fecal to oral, so if you're with inside the pool and you swallow the bacteria, you have the potential of becoming sick.
It just takes one accident by an infected person to contaminate the water. The CDC says outbreaks of crypto are on the rise across the country, and it was a big problem for some Ohio pools last year.
I talked with health departments here in the valley, and they say that there have been no recent reports of crypto here in our area, but they check in with public pools regularly to make sure they're properly cleaning and to make sure their chemicals are just right.
Water chemistry is important because you want to ensure that you have adequate disinfection with inside the pool.
Terry has been the pool manager at Firestone Pool for 36 years, and they've never had an issue with a waterborne illness. To make sure swimmers stay safe, they check chemicals often.
We check at least 7 or 8 times a day, and we're very proficient on that. We try to stay up on it all the time.
But they also need parents' help to keep the water safe and clean.
That's why that we have a 45-minute swim each hour, then a 15-minute break, and that gives the kids and adults time to get out, use the restroom.
If your kids have recently had diarrhea, keep them home.
Give yourself a couple weeks, at least 2 weeks, is a safe number to usually allow it to get through your system and not be able to pass it to other people.
He also suggests showering before jumping in. If you have little ones that require diapers, never change them near the pool. And the best way to protect yourself, never swallow pool water. In Columbiana, Alex George, WKBN 27 First News.